Hi all, in this video let's learn about how to generate OTP using JavaScript. So this video is for the beginners, so let me explain you. So OTP in general will be using for the two-factor authentication or any of the purposes will be using the OTPs. How to generate that OTP, let's discuss. So firstly, let me take an OTP length. Okay, I have taken OTP length. For now, let me give it as 4. So you can make this 4 or 6, or you can dynamically pass to this method, okay? And you can generate that, how many, the length of the OTP you can generate. And I'm taking a variable called OTP. Let me take this as a string, okay? Now, we'll save the OTP in this OTP variable. Now, let me take one loop. I'm rotating through the loop till the length which we have given. So 4 times this loop would be iterated. So now we have a for loop. Now we need to use math.random. So let me explain about this math.random. Math.random is a static method, okay, and it returns a floating number. So from 0, so let me comment here and write including 0 and excluding 1. So in between these values, okay, floating value would be given. So math.random will be generating that. Okay, so you can multiply that with 10 or 9 or any number so that it would round it to one number. Okay, that is what we are doing. So in general, math.random, it will give you a floating number. So now what you are doing, math.floor. So why we are doing this floor means this floor will down to the nearest integer. In short, if you get a number like 2.4, it would be converted into, because OTPs will not be in decimal numbers, right? So if a random generated number is like 2.4, something like that, the floor function will down this function to the nearest value. So now 2.4, the nearest downing is 2. So this is how the math.floor is going to do. And now we need to, this will return the number, right? We will store that number in an OTP, in this variable. And now, till it iterates for 4 times, we need to store this for 4 times. So that's the reason. So this is like we are doing OTP plus like this. So initially OTP is empty and it returns some value. It is storing the OTP. Again, you iterate for 4 times and 4 unique numbers would be getting into here and you are adding that to the OTP. So we are writing this in a shortcut way. So just keep a plus here. That means like we are appending the random values into this OTP variable. So let's return back this OTP. That's it. So let me show you this. I'm clearing this. I run it. See, 5204. So like this, you'll be getting. Okay, now if you want to pass the length as 6. So now if you pass a 6, see, 6 digits OTP you are getting. So OTP in sense, this is not an secured or encrypted way of thing. Okay, it needs an additional layer to do that. Okay, but at a high level, if you call this function at any point, you will be getting this updated OTPs. Like you, if you want 4 digits, if you want 6 digits, you can generate the OTP, that number, how many digits of OTP you want, that you can pass here and you can use that as a variable here. So that dynamically, sometimes you want 4 numbers, sometimes you want 6 numbers, you can do that. So this is how you can easily generate the OTP using JavaScript. Hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.